Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David and I see this all the time on our Twitter and all the social media. You guys are biased, East Coast biased. You know what? You keep watching these Pac-12 teams, you're going to have some West Coast bias. A wide open offensive league, great innovation. Defenses are tough and athletic as well. We're expecting a tremendous matchup in the Pac-12 in this one. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, which becomes the site for this football contest.
And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Lewis has the ball set how he wants it. And we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks.
And he got all of this one. Great kick.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Washington's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Throws, falling back, and finds his man. Tackle
around the 37-yard line.
Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big gain.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice gain for the offense.
From their own 37-yard line, first down.
Here we go!
He's taken down
around the 40-yard line.
A gain of 3 yards by the fullback.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
The Huskies always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 47.
Mike one. Strip that ball.
Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Caught, and he's brought down quickly.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
Caught, open field. And down he goes
around the 33-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33.
Mike one.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 33-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. 6 yards there on the counter.
That'll bring up third and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Throws complete. He's got space to work. They'll bring him down at about the 19-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. He's tackled around the 16-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 16-yard line. And they got him for a loss.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. There's a strike complete, and they make the stop at the 12. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow, having to leave the field knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
Washington could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. High-powered offenses everywhere. TCU grabs a 5-point win. In other games, the Bruins arrive at today's game ranked 24th in the country. The Bruins strike first with a rushing touchdown. UCLA has the lead 7-0.
And for the Huskies, now they know with a win today that they should move up in the polls. Walton looks ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Oh, he got nailed on that one. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's got it with room to run. Brought down at the 32. Ferguson picks up 6 yards with that grab.
That brings him second and five.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. And he's taken down right around the 32-yard line.
Third down.
To that quickly, and he's tackled at the 49-yard line.
A tight end that has this young man's skills is a real weapon for any offense. He can catch the ball, create mismatches, and force a defense to pay attention to him.
From the 49-yard line, it's first down. He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 33.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
From the 33-yard line, first down. Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That'll make it second and four.
Tie left.
Three down.
I'm coming.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Strike to the back, no good.
I'd like to see them roll the dice here and go for it. If you can't convert, let your defense go to work with a long field behind them.
So the officials taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, they get it right after the review. They call it a catch, and play will continue. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. And he hits him hard at the 26. Huge play for the defense. It'll be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Washington holds a field goal lead. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. It's second down, seven to go. Ball in the 29. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start, offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
Here's the halfback. And they'll get him in the backfield. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. Third and 14. Ball on the 22. Caught with room to work. He steps out right around the 28-yard line. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little. Knight is back deep to return. Brought down at the 38-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
First and 10, ball on the 47-yard line. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. Quarter of play. We've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Washington leads it 3-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Tries to set up a screen for the wide receiver. And they'll bring him down behind the line. And they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That'll make it third and nine.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37.
Three down, three down.
Here they come. He airs it out. He's hit and taken down.
Once this guy gets into the secondary, he can be a real problem to bring down. He can shake off a lot of tacklers who are smaller than he is.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. He gets out to about the 6 yard line. Zone intercepted.
He has to make better decisions than that. He should have known that there was no room to squeeze that ball in there.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Washington is up by three. Makes it to the 22-yard line. A 2 yard run by the halfback.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down.
Here we go. Oh, here we go. Oh, run for the mic. Watch one.
Set.
One.
180.
Run, run, run.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. From their own 21-yard line. Third down. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Knight is the deep man awaiting the return. He's taken down at the 39.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Tackle around the 49-yard line. From the 49-yard line, first down. Quick pass. He's taken down at the 42.
Number 48 brings him down at the 42-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That'll make it third and one.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Three down, three down.
Hey, Mike 51, Mike 51.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and four.
Munoz. He's going to try to kick this one deep. Let's see if he can get it inside the five. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Washington has a three-point lead. Throws it away. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 20. Nice run, and he's brought down. A first down. Finds the junior.
Well, it was third down, so they obviously had to get to the sticks, and they did just that with this little pass play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. Nice gain as he works the right side.
Gain of 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
They come out on an empty backfield. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on play. Third down.
Third down again. It all going deep. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Touchdown. Big play. And he hits the PAT. So that's a 6-play, 80-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. The score now, 10-0. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Knight from the 2. Across the 30. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. It out to his receiver in a hurry, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. They complete the slant, good for 10.
Well, the receiver does a nice job on his route, and how about the throw by the quarterback? Perfect execution. And when those two things are going well, the offense has a good chance of picking up big yards.
Gets to about the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 44. Slings it. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
Number one, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 44-yard line. Second down.
Three down. Hey, Mike 51.
And they make the stop at the 45-yard line.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Go back to him on a quick throw. And down he goes at the 35. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. The short yardage defense here. Runs it left for a decent game. Oregon will have one timeout remaining. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 30. This one's going deep to the end zone.
Terrific coverage. And when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. It has the distance, and it's good. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese,
time to get you up to date on some scores from around the country. This is a game we've been watching closely today. UCLA has the lead, 28-14.
10-3 game here. Points were very hard to come by in those first two quarters. They'll head to the locker room. 10-3, Washington.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got our back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great, too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a 5-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games. And you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get some in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Taken from the 3-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Quickly, and he's got his man. Brought down at the 33-yard line. That's a nice 6-yard gain.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's tackled at about the 35. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. at midfield. And he's taken down at the 41. First and 10. Ball on the 41. Give to the tailback. And he's tackled at the 38.
That's a gain of three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
Three down, three down.
Mike, get you one. Mike, get you one.
Ready. Put on and five.
Pulls it in, and he could score. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. That gives him 100 yards in the game.
He poses a lot of problems for defenses with his size and skill, and he's really come through with his receiving today.
First down, and they are very close to tying this thing up. They're back in the red zone where they have really struggled lately. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. And he's leveled at the one-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and goal.
All day, dog.
Mike 51! Mike 51!
They go with the run. Touchdown, Oregon!
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Bruins moved into the rankings at number 24 this week. Will they be able to maintain their position? And we've been keeping an eye on this one all day. The Bruins deliver the perfect connection and a touchdown. The Bruins lead it by a comfortable 3 touchdowns.
And for Oregon, they met up with Stanford last week. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. He fights forward to about the 26. Second and 9. Ball on the 26-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 28-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He gets hit out of bounds at the 44.
Gain of 16 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. 5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's under pressure. Complete across the middle. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does. And he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
First and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Fires to his receiver, first down. Tackle at the 17-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Makes it to the 8. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play.
That brings up second and 1.
Check tight right, tight right, tight right. Follow out there, check the outs out there. Go down.
Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. To the halfback, touchdown. And he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Washington is lining up to kick this one off. Knight takes it at the 4. Brought down at the 30. Washington's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Carries the ball for a nice gain. Jacobs gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 6.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's taken down around the 46-yard line.
I think play action's a big part of this offense and what they're trying to do today. It's, you know, they're running the football and they're mixing in some play action. And what that does is it freezes the linebackers and the safeties and puts a lot of pressure on them to have to be able to defend both the run and the play action. And as a play caller, when I know I can go to play action pass, boy, I feel really good about it. It's getting my quarterback in rhythm, slowing down the defense, and giving us a chance to make big play.
Here's the screen to the wideout. Tackle made at the 45.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
From the 45-yard line, second down. Caught with room to work. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. They'll work the left. He tackles him for a loss.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 35-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Tight end left, tight end left.
3 down.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Let's go.
Motion.
Red 68. Red 68.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
That's a loss of 8 yards.
sack makes this a fourth and very long. Tidwell is back awaiting the punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
They'll go ground. They'll drop him for a loss. It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on their own 18. Washington is up 7. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 on the play. Third down.
We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 17-10, Husky. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He heaves it deep. Doesn't get there.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
Knight is back to receive. Knight fields it at the 34, and he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. He might not be able to get the pass off, and they got him.
That is a loss of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. Hand off to the right. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line. From the 36-yard line, first down. And they make the stop at the 34. Picked up almost 4 on that halfback delay.
That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Three down. Mike 51.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Hand off, and he's met immediately. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
One thing the coaches always say about this sophomore is that he has great lateral movement. That lets him move well behind this defensive line and get after a lot of plays in the running game.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Nice run up the middle. Jacobs gets 6 yards on the play.
That'll make it 35.
They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. They come out in an empty backfield. Gets it out quickly. Touchdown, Ducks.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes, so kudos to the quarterback. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 54-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Oregon to kick. He just drills this one. The finish line's in sight. Let's see who wants this one more.
At the very least, they've got to get in the field goal range. Once they've done that, they can think about taking a few shots into the end zone.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Brought down around the 37-yard line.
Number 18 on the tackle, the 37-yard line.
From their own 37-yard line, first down.
Here we go! 180! 180!
And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. About the 39-yard line. Third and eight. Ball on their own 39. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He'll take it from the 18. Tackle at the 25. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Takes the ball inside. And he's taken down at the 25-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Quick pitch, and he goes nowhere.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That makes it third and 15.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Tidwell takes it at the 45. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. we might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down.
Mike Wood, Mike Wood.
Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on the 13-yard line. Just over a minute left.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
And he's tackled right around the 4-yard line.
That's a deep number. That makes it first and goal.
Let's go one more. Mike won. Mike won.
Here we go. Right 80.
Touchdown, Huskies. He hits the PAT. It was a 5-play, 44-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook try. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Walton ready to kick from the 7. He's got the corner. And he just got stood up right there. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Knocked out of bounds at the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. And they push him out at the 48. Under a minute left. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. That was a great call.
Yeah, here you see the draw play at its best. The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. He goes downtown. And he's got it. And he will score. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Just under a minute left in the fourth quarter, and this game hasn't failed to disappoint. 24-24 is the score. Oregon gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
Tackle right around the 38-yard line.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. They bring him down.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Knight is back deep to return the punt. And he just got drilled.
They could take a shot or two, but with this little time left on the clock, they may just want to take a knee and play for overtime.
We're late in the fourth quarter. Great game. A tied football game. And the question now is, who's going to rise to the occasion? Quick throw. Tackle made at the 49. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From their own 49-yard line. First down. They'll have one more chance for the end zone. He wants it all. This one will fall incomplete. That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Tight end grab. First down. He's taken down around the 4-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Is out and the ball is up for grabs. It's recovered.
Two tights.
Three down.
They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
Seems like every game, this guy's in the offense's backfield, bringing guys down for a loss. He's just got a knack for making plays.
It's third and goal. Ball on the 12-yard line. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's hit and taken down. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese?
The Wildcats come in today's game ranked number 6. And for Kansas State, their hot streak continues. The Wildcats get the W, 20-14. Elsewhere, the Bruins were sitting at number 24. And after this victory, they hope to slide up a few spots. And for Stanford, that's now 9 straight losses. The Bruins win it big.
Reese, we're separated by a field goal here, 27-24. From
from the 25-yard line. First down. They come out in a five-wide set. Slings it out there incomplete. Makes his way out to about the 15. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down.
Here we go.
Wide open, and he just drops it.
Well, the execution here is very good by the offense. The quarterback did a nice job of reading the defense and put the ball in a position to be able to make the catch. The problem is the wide receiver did not focus and concentrate and hold on to the ball.
It's up, and it sails through the uprights.
He looked totally calm there, didn't he? He knew what he had to do, and he just drilled it.
Well, it's going to take another round at least. You can bet the coaches are going to look to be more aggressive on both sides of the ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Catches it, and that's all.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision making.
That'll bring up second and three.
And they make the stop at the 10.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
First down. From the 10-yard line, it's first down. To that quickly. That's a great tackle at the 9-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Kent with a nice play fake. Finds the tight end for a touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. It's first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Easy, 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 easy.
Deep pass to the end zone. And he scores. Touchdown. So the offense comes up big, and now they're just an extra point away from a third overtime period.
I know we usually don't talk about extra points being big kicks, but they don't get much more important than this one.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT.
Both teams are dead tired, but one is going to outlast the other. This is looking like a classic in the making.
From the 25-yard line, first down. Zips it to the tight end, and he's immediately tackled. Jacobs gains about 5 yards on the run.
That brings him second and five.
Second down and five. Ball on the 9-yard line.
Down. Mike 51. Mike 51.
1 and 8. 5.
he just gets rid of it. From the 3 yard line, second down. All the big boys are on the field now. Both teams have their big sets out there. And he's taken down at the 1 yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 3rd and goal.
Scrambling around, and he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. So the offense comes up big and gets 6 points here in triple overtime.
And unless they want to leave this in the hands of their defense, they better come up big here again because they have to go for the 2-point conversion.
Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion. Oregon up 6. And they get the 2. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. Complete. He's got room. Brought down at the 14-yard line.
Gain of 11 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Man left, man left. Four down. Mike one. Here we go.
Takes a handoff. Tackled for a loss. From the 15-yard line, second down, 5 wide. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over.
Throws in a hurry. And they couldn't hook up on that one. This might be their last chance. Fourth down. He goes out of bounds at the 10-yard line. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, Oregon 42, Washington 34. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action in this one?
This is the kind of game you just love if you're a fan. Exciting, hard fought, coming right down to the end and then some. Oregon was looking at a mirror image across the field today. I'm not at all surprised that this game went on as long as it did.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.